This is the infinity symbol, widely recognized, and most people have at least a vague idea of what it represents. However, the depth of knowledge we can extract from this concept is truly remarkable. The symbol we use to represent infinity has a name, although few people are aware of it. It's called a lemniscate, originating from Latin. The concept of infinity is one of the most comprehensive philosophical themes ever explored by humanity. The idea of infinity, something transcending everything, can evoke a range of emotions. Some people may feel absorbed by this concept, experiencing a sense of smallness, irrelevance, and emptiness, especially when contrasting the infinite with the daily reality of limitations and scarcity. On the other hand, others may feel inspired by the challenge of contemplating and exploring something so vast with the naturally limited human mind. The notion of infinity has been a constant source of reflection on the nature of the world and the human mind. Right now, let's explore the following question. Is there something infinite in the world? To assist our quest, let's revisit the ancient Greek version of this same question. Aristotle categorized infinity into two classes, potential infinity and actual infinity. There are things with the potential to be infinite, such as counting. We can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 theoretically without ever stopping. But in practice, at some point, we'll need to halt the counting since we have other responsibilities and commitments in life. This represents potential infinity. The other facet of infinity is actual infinity, which transcends ideas and manifests itself in the world in all its magnitude. Aristotle didn't believe that something truly infinite existed in the world, only things that were potentially infinite. However, our worldview is considerably different from that of the ancient Greeks. So, let's attempt to answer the question that inspired this video in a more contemporary manner. Does infinity exist in our universe? A relevant starting point to seek our answer is to consider time. However, we often fail to deeply contemplate the full extent of time. As of now, nothing in physics suggests that time will ever come to an end. The universe will continue to expand and evolve for an infinite period. Trillions and trillions of years from now, only low-energy radiation will remain in the universe. Nonetheless, all indications are that time will keep flowing second by second. It's worth noting that the infinite time we will have in the future is only potentially infinite because, even if humanity somehow manages to endure until the arrival of the universe's heat death, no human being will experience an infinitesimal second of time. While there may be human beings far in the distant future, none of them will truly be immersed in the infinite. Another possible approach is to reverse the trajectory of our clock and seek infinity in the past. According to our current best scientific understanding, the beginning of the universe and, therefore, of time, dates back to an event that occurred about 13.8 billion years ago, marking the onset of the Big Bang. However, there are universe models that seek to explain what happened before that, including theories of cyclic universes, in which our Big Bang was just one among many. In these concepts, the universe exists in an eternal cycle of beginning, ending, beginning, ending, beginning, and ending. If this is the case, then here we encounter our first realized infinity, a true infinity. There are two ways to express this infinity. The first is that the universe indeed operates in a cycle of beginning, ending, and restarting. If this is true, then there have been infinite universes that came before ours. Otherwise, we would already be in infinite seconds into the future. This constitutes a realized infinity, since infinite seconds have passed in infinite universes. The second way is that the universe's cycles repeat. For instance, there may be only 12 possible stories of the universe that continually repeat. If this is the case, there are only 12 universes in the cycle, but each one repeats infinitely. We are part of the universe, which means you are the infinitely repeated version of yourself. And here's another potential realized infinity. We don't know the ultimate fate or the beginning of our universe. We are uncertain about these infinities, but they are entirely plausible as far as we know. The same holds true for the extent of our universe. The space within the universe might be infinite. The universe we can observe is limited with a diameter of about 100 billion light years, but the boundary of our sight is not the limit of space. Perhaps there is more universe beyond that, and maybe there is an infinite amount of universe out there. If that's the case, there could be infinite stars, infinite galaxies, and infinite planets in the universe. Who knows? There might even be infinite intelligent civilizations, most of which will never encounter each other because even in an infinite universe, the speed of light is finite and it's impossible to escape your own bubble in this infinite space. But it's not only in the vastness of space and time that infinity may reside. Perhaps infinity hides in the minuscule as well. For instance, consider the space between two hands. How many possible locations exist between them? If space is perfectly continuous, like the mathematical line between 0 and 1, then there are infinite possible positions in space. A particle could be 10 centimeters from the hands, or 10.01 centimeters, or 10.91 centimeters, or any infinity of different possibilities. And this infinity literally fits between the two hands. There are infinite points of space between two hands. The same question applies to time. If time is continuous and smooth, then there are infinite moments in time, and every second, you've passed through infinite instants. But what if that's not the case, and time and space aren't infinite? Who knows? They might be like a grid or pixels on a screen. Perhaps there's a minimum possible size in space and a smaller fraction of time. If that's true, then there's an enormous number of points between two hands, but there isn't infinity. And there's also a limited, finite number of moments in every second, assuming space is indeed perfectly continuous, and a point in space has perfectly zero volume. This leads us to another potential hidden infinity, and it's quite concealed, actually, within black holes. Behind the event horizon, from which not even light can escape. According to traditional calculations of Einstein's general relativity, the formation of a black hole compresses a vast amount of matter into a point of zero volume and infinite density, something called a singularity. The usual interpretation of the singularity is that it represents the point where Einstein's general relativity fails. The idea is that from a tiny distance, the quantum effects of gravity need to be considered, and that tiny distance is the Planck length. Beyond the Planck length, quantum gravity would prevent the formation of this infinite density, becoming repulsive in some way. In general, physicists don't like infinities in the real world, but if space is genuinely continuous and there's no minimum length, the singularity might very well be infinite. After all, if there are infinite points in every millimeter of space, then why would an infinite density be any stranger? It even contradicts these space infinities that various theories of quantum gravity make space quantized. In other words, they posit that there's indeed a minimum length for space. Quantum space would be made up of pixels, according to most theories of quantum gravity. However, we still don't know if this is indeed the case. And that brings us to the last potential place for infinity, at least in potential, a place even more intimate than anything else. Perhaps infinity resides in your mind, and I don't mean this only in the abstract concept of infinity. Maybe there are endless possible different thoughts. In other words, humanity could continue to exist for all conceivable future and never exhaust all the thoughts that could exist. Think about it. There's an intriguing thought experiment to argue that there are infinite thoughts. Think of something. Now, no matter what you just thought of, you can create a new thought simply by thinking about what you just thought. This becomes a second thought, distinct from the first. And you can repeat the process by thinking about what you thought, thus creating an infinite chain of distinct thoughts from a single thought. So, the human mind might be, at least potentially, infinite. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you'd like to help the channel get closer to achieving numbers that approach infinity, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you very much, and until next time.